Dara, welcome to ETGBS. Now, my colleague Supriya got to interview you yesterday morning, so now I know three things about you that I didn't know before. One, of course, the thing that he misses the most about Iran is food, that he loves playing Dungeons and Dragons, and his favorite entrepreneur is not anyone sitting in this room, but is Prime Minister Modi. Why Prime Minister Modi? We've just been politically correct.
No, because it's actually very difficult as an entrepreneur to be entrepreneurial at scale. You know, the bigger you get, the more bureaucratic institutions tend to get, the more no is an easy answer. And I think that what the Prime Minister is doing in terms of pushing India forward with a global view, pushing progressive reforms forward, and keeping the country open, and you see the optimism as far as where the economy is going, is remarkable. And to be entrepreneurial at scale is a skill that hopefully I can find as I take over Uber and look to scale the company to the next level.
You've had a pretty busy 2 days, action-packed schedule. How has India treated you so far?
It's been great. This is my first time in India. I've never been here, and the market for us is a very, very important market. Not only in terms of our business today, but more importantly, where it's going to be 5 to 10 years from now. And for me, it's just been a jolt of pure energy. This morning was my favorite because we got to sit down with some of our driver partners and talk about our product and talk about how we can improve. And there are plenty of suggestions in terms of where we can improve.
What was the quirkiest of them all? I mean, the one that took you by surprise.
We have our number one priority for us this year is standing for safety. Everyone wants, wherever you are in the globe, we want our platform to be the safest mobility platform. And usually you take that in the context of it being safe for the passenger. But the drivers were talking about safety as it relates to them. One little example is that they're always encouraging passengers to put on their seatbelt, and the passenger sometimes says, no, I don't want to put on your seatbelt. So we were talking about whether we can incentivize passengers to put on their seatbelt as well. So that was a little bit of a surprise. But the great story is that we are allowing their 300,000 micro-entrepreneurs on our platform now who are making a living, who are earning the respect of their families and their kids, et cetera, by earning a living on our platform. And they truly are micro-entrepreneurs who are figuring out all the rules and the bells and whistles on that platform to use it in their own way. So it was great to see.
You managed to meet a whole host of policymakers in Delhi. The one meeting I'm curious to know about is with Jayant Sinha, Minister of State for Aviation. Does that indicate that you have plans to bring your flying cars to India soon, and how soon?
Well, I don't want to announce anything before it's time to announce it, but listen, it's as urban mobility scales, and to some extent a number of the technologies that we're bringing to bear in terms of mobility, including sharing, are designed to lower costs and to lower congestion as well. But as you lower costs, demand for more mobility is going to come in. More and more people are going to move into cities all around the world. And just as we went vertical in terms of office space, and just as we went vertical in terms of residences in these super cities, we're going to have to go vertical in terms of transportation. And that's, for us, that's what Uber Elevate is all about. And we are absolutely open for dialogue and open for business. And it is something that we'd love to bring to India sometime down the road.